I'm in neutral. So down one. Four. Okay, four speed then it is. Look at that. And I'm back in neutral. Crazy. The really scary thing about that, so if right now I'm in I'm back in neutral. So if I go here, okay, and I think I'm in first, and then I would go into fourth. I would end right back up in first gear. So imagine going along at 20 mile an hour, shifting, and ended up in first gear. You're going to be over the handlebars. Stupid, stupid dangerous. We're going to do a little research. We're going to find out, is this one vehicle, or is this common to these imports? If it is, I can't believe there's one of them that's even allowed into the States. So
we went ahead and removed the clutch cover here. This is pretty standard shift paw arrangement here. So, yeah, when you shift, we move that drum on the top there, back and forth. Okay. And once we move our selected to our selected gear, this detent, if you will, holds it in that position. It's real common on most multiple speed constant mesh transmission that I call this the star. And one of these is usually half notched, and that would be like your neutral position. So go ahead and take a look here. I went and grabbed some out of my stash of just common motorcycles here, and I believe these first two were Buells. It's just one out of a Yamaha, but check it out. When I talk about that star, you can see that you have the full indents, just like on that Taiwan one, but we've got this one that's just, you know, I call it mooned. That is always your neutral position. I mean, it's very textbook on any of these transmissions. Get a little top view on that. So like this would be first gear, neutral, and second. All this does is allow that detent arm that I showed you earlier to set there, and that's the held position for neutral, if you will. But what we really have going on is that track must just continue right on around. There's nothing stopping it, so like it has an end point, so that's just allowing that to just keep on running all the way through and shifting over between the gears. Now that's a guess, because I'll get in there and split the cases and we'll see what happens. But I think we're gonna find out, is we don't have these stopping tracks in here. We will go ahead and pull the motor, split the cases. I have an idea how to fix it, even if it is a design flaw, to make this where it'll be usable. So it'll be kind of a fun project. Go ahead and comment below if you're familiar with these Asian clones and you've either seen a fix or have a comment about it. All right, make it a great day and keep wrenching. I hope you found this video useful. If you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, would you please do so? Also hit that notification button so you'll know about all our future videos. As I always say, keep wrenching and make it a great day.